Yeah, I think in this crisis, Europe really came together fairly quickly, decided fast. We had the first package agreed in the Eurogroup, Euro area finance ministers, already in May, adding up to 540 billion euro. So quick reaction, big volume, well coordinated also with the between the European institutions, including the European Central Bank, Commission, ESM, national governments. And then in July, of course, we had the big decision in the European Council on the next generation EU. So all that together is really big money. And I also hear this in the markets again and again, that many people in the markets tell me we are more positive on Europe than the last 10 years ever, because of the quick reaction, the big volume of money, and the good coordination.
We've lived through many crises over the last 20, 30 years in Europe, and of course since the creation of the Eurozone as well. I'm surprised at how quick Europe got its act together. I'm surprised at the coordination. I'm surprised Italy looks like it's back in the fold. But it doesn't matter what I think. Are you?
Yeah, no. But I think one thing to understand is that this crisis is really different from the other crises. We had the Euro crisis 8-10 years ago, a few years before that, the global financial crisis, and then a few dot-com bubbles burst and all of that. So you're right, many crises. But this is a different type of crisis. It was a symmetric shock hitting every European country, we can say every country in the world. That was something unprecedented. That's also why the economic damage is the worst in our lifetime. Very different. When I compared with the Euro crisis, there it was 4 or 5 countries that were affected because they had implemented wrong policies for a number of years and there had to be corrections. They lost market access. So it was quite dramatic for a few countries, and the others had to organize how to help them. It was new. This time, I think everybody understood we are all affected. We are all in this together. We all have to get out of it because we want to preserve the single market of the European Union, and we have to make sure monetary union works well. That's why there is this unprecedented degree of solidarity.
And again, maybe I'll get you to comment on this extraordinary comment just made from Mr. Letta and agreed by Mr. Borrell as well, that actually G7, G20, international coordination, it's been missing in action. I thought that was a very interesting phrase, missing in action. Would you agree that actually the global coordination has been quite frankly hopeless?
Yeah, very different from the global financial crisis when the G20 really got into action and agreed on very useful fiscal stimulus. But of course, we know why it's so different this time. The United States has moved away from multilateralism. There is a big conflict between China and the US. So I think what we in the European Union have known for a long time, that we are fairly well coordinated, doesn't mean that we always say the same thing from the beginning. But we know how to cooperate. We know how to deal with a crisis. We do get together in the end. Europe, the European Union, has the highest degree of cooperation of any continent, any region in the world, and that is developing in a good direction, and we saw that in this crisis, while the US is moving away from multilateralism.